Jaskała.
Let's look at how to use SigmaWin Plus to do a position control mode application using the SigmaWin Plus parameter wizard. So here's the application. Let's just review that quickly. We're going to be simulating a rotary index table directly driven by an SGM AV motor commanded by a standalone controller. Here's the simplified connection diagram. The output format is listed as step and direction. So the controller is sending step and direction to the amplifier. And this indexer, this controller, is programmed so that each command pulse represents 0.01 degrees. So one pulse here from the controller, the motor should go 0.01 degrees. By the way, that's called the reference unit when you are referring to the amplifier. We have the output SO1 connected here. We want that to turn on whenever the position error goes below 0.1 degrees. And we'll use that in the indexer controller to confirm that the motor is in position at the end of the move. The encoder feedback resolution must be set so that each post quad count back to the controller represents 0.01 degree of motion completed. So you see how that works here. The controller is going to send a pulse to the amplifier, and we want the encoder feedback, when it's read as quadrature, encoder feedback to also show that that 0.01 degree of motion has taken place. The indexer has one output for turning the servo on. See that here. And when we turn this servo on input off, we'd like that to clear any faults in the amplifier. And the last two here says if the position error rises above 90 degrees, if we get 90 degrees behind in the amplifier, we want to have the amplifier fault out, position error overflow. And also we would like to have a warning when we get halfway there, 45 degrees. So to solve this simplified application story, here's what I'll do. I'll initialize the parameters, go into the setup wizard and the editor to set up all the parameters according to this application. I'm going to label the terminals here so that when I do have to wire up the controller, I'll know exactly what my connections are. I'll look at the parameters that were changed, and then using my demo, I'd like to verify that this was going to work before I attach the real controller. So in SigmaWin Plus, we'll go to the parameters and hit initialize. Okay. And it does say that I need to change of parameters requires restart. I will wait to do that until I have finished all of the other parameters. So now let's start the wizard by going to Setup Wizard under the parameter menu. And the first step is always to do this apply to not using the fully closed encoder. Under control mode, I select position control, the pulse train reference, and hit apply. Now for the reference input setting, we have these different formats that the controller can send its pulses. We have said that the output format is listed as step and direction. So I'm going to use sine and pulse, which is equivalent to step and direction. You got pulses on one channel and high or low for direction on the other channel. That's likely to be the most common format for controllers operating in position mode. There's a choice here for positive logic in the case that your pulses go from high to low. Negative logic for that case, and then from low to high is positive logic. I'll just stick with positive logic, and the controller would list whether it's positive or negative or give it a drawing. I'm going to assume positive logic. Now we get to this electronic gear function, and what this means is we need to set the reference unit. I'm going to recommend that when you do this, you do the electronic gear details. This lets you choose a mechanical system that best fits the description of your machine. If none of these can be used with your machine, you can go back and enter the parameters directly. But I said I have an index table, and so I think this round table, it's called here, will work out just fine. First question is gear ratio, and you can see this is referring to a mechanical gear between the motor and the table. I don't have that. It says that it's directly driven by an SGM AV motor. So I'll leave that at 1:1. Next, here's the reference unit, and this refers to the distance that the machine should move when one pulse comes from the controller. We call that the reference unit, and I wanted to set that to 0.01 degrees. So see here, that's been set to 0.001 degrees by default. I'll go into modify and just knock off a zero here. And also on this page is the position completed with, which has to do with the coin output signal. Coin means position coincides. The actual position and the commanded position coincide within a certain tolerance set by the parameter PN522. And we had mentioned that in the application that we want this output, SO1, to turn on so we can get that signal back to the controller whenever the position is within 0.1 degrees. So if my reference unit is 0.01 degrees and we're asking for the position completed with in reference units, then I'll need 10 reference units to get to 0.1 degrees, and I'll hit apply for that. Moving on to the motor encoder setting, we are able to set the number of pulses per motor rotation, and here I've said that the encoder feedback resolution must be set so that each post quad count back to the controller represents 0.01 degree of motion completed. This is actually what's happening here, where it says set the dividing output according to the electronic gear ratio. Why 9,000? Well, 9,000 is pre-quad pulses, so after quad that would be 36,000. Basically, you can see that if the reference unit is 0.01 degrees, then 360 degrees equals 36,000 reference units. Since this parameter is given as pre-quad pulses, we'll need to divide that 36,000 by 4. So 36 divided by 4 is 9. So just hit apply here. We'll leave the absolute encoder as absolute encoder and go on here to the direction. There was nothing indicated about the direction. We'll figure that out, I guess, once we see the table in motion. Just leave the standard setting and finish up here. Under motor stop, no specification was given how the motor should stop. Let's just leave that at default. Hit apply. And now for the I/O signal setting. For inputs, we see that the amplifier input servo on should also take the function of alarm reset when the servo on signal turns off, or when this input turns off. So I'll go into my input signal settings, and you see that I already have servo on, but alarm reset is on pin 44. So I can move that over and make it on the same pin. You notice that is somewhat of a warning here. They turn the text red. But then not only that, I can click on it again, and that reverses the allocation, meaning instead of normally open, it's normally closed. And so now when I open the connection to pin 40, I'll reset an alarm. And when I close the connection to pin 40, I'll turn the servo on. That's it for the inputs. The rest we'll leave at default. Probably not even going to use them, according to the wiring diagram. And it's warning me about the duplications here of servo on and alarm reset. Yes, I'm sure. Now for outputs, we're looking at this SO1 to be the coin output. If I look at my outputs, SO1 is coin. It's also velocity compare. And since velocity compare is not applicable in position mode, I can just leave this here. This is the default. And we'll apply that. Now for these other two that have to do with the position error, alarms and warnings, I can't really do those through the wizard. So I'll go into these parameters next here outside of the wizard. So I'll save the wizard. I like to save first, call it position mode. And then you can write with a backup file. Okay, and I'll finish. And yeah, I could cycle power, but I'll just go ahead and finish up with those other two parameters in the parameters list. And those were parameters PN520 and 51E. Under sequence, PN520, excessive position error alarm level. Let's open that one. It's given in reference units. And so if I wanted to have 90 degrees, I'll put in a 90, and then my reference unit was 0.01, so two more zeros. And then the warning level was supposed to be 45 degrees, but you'll notice the unit here is in percent. And that begs the question, percent of what? And typically when you see a percentage, if it's not listed what it's a percentage of, it would be a percentage of another parameter that's related to it. And in this case, we're talking about percent of the 90 degrees. So although I want 45 degrees, I don't enter 45, I enter 50%, because 45 is 50% of 90. And I'll write those over. Right, now I'm done with my parameters. I'll close it and cycle power. Best practice is to reconnect, so file reconnect. and I'm back into the software. So let me go through here and label the terminals. Servo on and alarm reset. This is going to be wired to pin 40, CN1. Encoder feedback. I'd always refer to the wiring check under the monitor if you don't know the pin numbers. Encoder feedback is over here, PAO, PBO, PCO. So that was 33, 34, 35, and 36. And the last one here, 19 and 20. And then output SO1 right here is pin 25 and 26. 25, 26. And it's just good practice to have your pin numbers labeled so when you go to wire it, you've got it all in one place and you know exactly where to wire to. I'm missing the command reference here, step and direction. And that's up here to the reference here, pulse and sign, 7 and 8 and 11 and 12. 7 and 8, 11 and 12. So where am I at? I have initialized the parameters. I used the setup wizard and the parameter editor. I labeled my terminals. I could see a list of the parameters that have been changed by going to the parameters menu again, opening up differ from constant, and just take a look here. Be sure that everything is in place. And now let's verify operation on the demo. So the first thing I can do here to check out this application is to use these monitors, reference, pulse, feedback, and deviation. So let's go find those here. We've got the deviation counter. That's better described as the position error. There's the reference pulse counter. That's counting the pulses from the controller. And feedback is counting the encoder pulses feedback from the motor. So I've now enabled the servo. And I'm going to give a reference pulse through my demo by turning the wheel one click. So you can see I got one reference pulse now. And the feedback pulse counter went to 16. Do one more. I've got two. Feedback pulse counter went to 44. So why is the feedback pulse counter going so much higher? It's because of that electronic gear ratio parameter. The motor's encoder is moving the equivalent of 0.01 degrees, which in encoder counts is a much higher number out of the million per revolution encoder counts. Also, I can see that if I were to put my hand on the motor, let's watch the deviation counter. I would apply some force to it. You can see the deviation counter goes up and down. And then also if I go to wiring check, I can see the coin output will turn off if I go out of position. So it goes from low to high. High means off, low means conducting circuit. The other feature that had to do with position error was to get a warning or an alarm by moving the motor in over travel. This could happen during motion, but to test it out, it's really hard to overpower the motor by 45 or 90 degrees unless you put the demo into over-travel condition. So let's keep an eye now on the deviation counter and I'll hit the over-travel inputs. You can see I've done that. Now I'll start to turn the motor. You can see the deviation counter now is going way up. That's the position error going way up. So 42.78 means 42.78. Now it says 4149. That's 41.49 degrees. And if I go up here a little bit above 45, you can see I've got the overflow warning. And if I keep going, I get the position error pulse overflow. And I can go take a look at that alarm. And you'll see that if I scroll down a little bit, the deviation counter did go right about up to 90 degrees. Now for the PN212 setting, I did already explain why that's 9,000. Because the pre-quadrature is 9,000, post-quadrature would be 36,000, which is the number of reference units per rotation. And then finally, let's use program jog to move the motor one revolution. How many reference units are required? The answer to that would be 36,000, so that I get 360 degrees out of my 0.01 reference unit. So before I go into program jog, how about I try to reset the alarm by turning off the servo, and see that worked. Program jog's under test run, so I'll need 36,000 reference units. I can hit apply. Maybe I'll cut the speed down a little bit so it doesn't go too fast. Maybe 400. And let's cut down the XLD cell. Maybe down to 200. You can see how when I do that it adjusts the profile. And then I'll hit run. Servo on. And I still have my overtravels on. Put the overtravels back on. Program jog. And run. Yep, we're going to move. And take my word for it, it moved, and it moved one revolution. So that's it, a position control mode application using the wizard and SigmaWin Plus.